Recently, I shared a paper I found detailing the conservation problems associated with honeybees. It really got me thinking, since normally we see honeybees as something awesome we want to protect. I started wondering about some of the crops pollinated by honeybees and the environmental effects of those crops. I love eating almonds. They're nice, plain, toasted, rolled up in baked goods, covered in chocolate, or even squeezed into milk. My husband is lactose intolerant. And I'm not alone. Almonds have soared in popularity in the United States following scientific reports detailing a host of health benefits they can provide to people who eat them. Not to mention that almonds have gotten more trendy as rates of vegetarianism have increased. However, the news is not all good for almonds. It's usually not easy to grow just one species of food plant over hundreds of acres, and the actions we take to try and force nature to accommodate our agricultural endeavors can deplete resources and require a lot of work. And I'm not the only one who's concerned. Several other groups have already done a lot of digging on some of the problems with almonds. Links to these sources will be in the description. The biggest problem for most people is the amount of water needed to grow almonds. It takes approximately 1 gallon of water to produce one almond, which is kind of a lot when you consider the size difference. Part of the reason for this is that almonds grow on perennial trees that need to be watered throughout the year. This can be substantial in drought years, when other crop fields are allowed to go fallow to conserve water. These trees represent a continuous investment of space, energy, and other resources. This is bad news for water conservation, since most almonds are grown in California, which has been experiencing long-term drought conditions in some areas. Climatologists predict these droughts will increase in severity and longevity as conditions warm and change. On top of all of this, water usage laws in California are a little unconventional. Someone who wants to pump water from an underground stream can claim they are actually pumping surface water, since an underground stream runs in a channel. True groundwater has even fewer protections, with most decisions on rights and regulations being decided by the courts without becoming enforceable laws. And speaking of laws, water use for almonds is verging on causing environmental justice issues, too. Many low-income farm worker communities have experienced limited water use allowances and problems accessing clean drinking water because most potable water is being devoted to agriculture. On an ecosystem scale, agricultural requirements have caused large amounts of water to be diverted from rivers. Shallower, warmer rivers can cause Chinook salmon to die from a disease called gill rot. And yes, it's just as bad as it sounds for the fish. It's also not good for indigenous peoples living in the area who rely on the salmon as part of their way of life. No wonder people are upset. Negative press on the water issue has motivated almond farmers to work on their conservation behaviors, at least in this one area. Many farms are engaging in irrigation initiatives, and the Almond Board of California has a whole section of their website devoted to sustainability and water usage. But sustainability is about more than water, waste, and carbon footprints. Nowhere on the board's website does it talk about other conservation issues like pesticide and herbicide usage and honeybee pollination. And as we've already learned, honeybees are far from innocent when we think about conservation of North American ecosystems. Did you know that 30 billion honeybees are used to pollinate almonds in California each year? That's a lot of bees! Surprisingly, though, these bees don't originate in California. The hives are developed in other states and driven on trucks to get where they need to go. First, that means moving honeybees using a lot of fossil fuels, which is its own problem. But as the honeybee article reminded us, moving around large groups of bees is the perfect opportunity for disease transmission. Not to mention that moving that many non-native bees into California could be having harmful effects on native bee populations and their ability to support local ecosystems. So I still love almonds, and I'm not saying that I or anybody else should stop eating them, but it is important for us as consumers and environmentalists to be aware aware of where our food comes from, how it's made, and any conservation issues that may be part of the process. Hopefully, with more awareness, we'll be able to make positive changes when it comes to things like relying on honeybees to pollinate our crops. If you liked this video, don't forget to like it. If you didn't like this video, please share it with someone who would. And if you'd like to support the Roving Naturalist, remember to click the subscribe button and the bell notification icon. You can also follow me on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram, and read science posts on my blog. I'll also be a periodic contributor on the radio show Blue Dot, so you should go check that out as well. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.